Okay, this is going to be part two of the mid-70s P-Bass. And this one is what we call a smoker. That was just a tiny bit of cleaning I did right there. And, speaking of which, I did it again. I started this with my bare hands. We can't be having that. Just cause. But anyhow, guys will call this, you know, the patina. No, this is just shit. Even if the guy who owned it didn't smoke, he probably played in smoky bars. And that's what happened. So I'm not going to bore you with it. We're going to hit the broad strokes of this with some Simple Green just to get rid of the, you know, there's like mud on this thing. But you can already see this guitar will shine again. And once I get all the shit off it, we could probably polish it. And this has got some real relicking to it. Let's not pretend, but what's really cool is even after all that buckle rash, still couldn't beat its way through the sanding sealer underneath the finish. Crazy, huh? Okay, so forget you saw it like this, especially like in the areas where the black has been sprayed, it's turned, we don't know what color. Close your eyes, and in a couple of minutes, I am going to finish cleaning this. Well, no, for me, it's going to be more than a couple of minutes. Go have a smoke, come back, check it out. So if you are actually going to try this at home, don't be scared, because it's going to look a lot worse before it looks a lot better. And there's so much goo on the guitar over all these years that it'll get all slimy in it, and you'll think like I'm rubbing off the finish. That's not the finish. And you gotta keep getting new clean cloths, because as soon as this gets on there, you can't keep rubbing it back in the guitar or pushing it around the guitar. That's a first thing that'll happen, is it just gets all gooey and fucked up. And I have even gone to the point on some of these where I've taken like 2,000 grit wet dry sandpaper and literally wet sanded the goo off the guitar. You never get to the finish, it just turns into a mud puddle. But you can see it's really starting to come back. It's gonna look fucking great. Oh, I said that word. People are unsubscribing. Sorry. See, check that out. That was just shit colored. And now, that's what's going on. That's what's coming off this guitar. So you were looking through all that many years ago. I thought I would get smart. Well, I thought I'd try and get smart. And figured that, you know, I could just take the guitar and put it on the high-speed buffing wheel and use that heavy cut buffing compound, and that was gonna just peel all this shit off. No, it just made soup. And that's when I learned, if you want to do this right, you got to get all this old shit off of there. We're getting it. Just spare no expense on the Ronsonol. It ain't going to hurt nothing. It pretty much evaporates immediately. But little by little, it will get rid of all that shit. It's looking pretty good. I still think it deserves a spin on the wheel, but wow. And that's something. Once that pickguard's on there, the edges are really something. Like, I should have just, I should have, would have, could have. Yeah. Yeah, so that, some better light on that. Okay, so now we're gonna clean that. Then I'll show you. So there, that's that horn with all the mud cleaned off it, all the way around the whole guitar. We'll do the front and back again. And then we could waste some time with some high speed polishing. So there's been at least three of them that went in the garbage. And as you keep going around, you'll feel that with the clean cloth, you'll know when it's clean because it doesn't grab or it's not sticky at all anymore. And you keep working your way around, you'll find all the little spots you missed, like that one there. Yeah, keep going. Don't give up. It ain't clean till she's clean. I mean, seriously, what a difference that makes. I'm not done. Okay, you get the idea. A muddy old looking P bass with some chips and dings in it now just looks like a P bass from the 70s. Quick shot of the backside with lots of flare from the frickin' lights. That's the problem with all new lights, they're way too bright. That's still looking a little dingy, that horn there. I'm gonna probably go at that again. And even that one too, I can see where there's some dullness. But yeah, tomorrow I'll clean up all the metal parts, put that unbelievably well fret dress neck back on it, new strings. She's gonna rock. All right. Oh, I didn't plug in the fancy microphone. I will in a second. Time to reassemble the P bass. And I think it's going to be pretty good. There, the fancy microphone is now on. And, you know, I, in an attempt to try and satisfy the many directors of photography who have graced me with their, you know, expertise and all that stuff. It's sort of like this, guys. It's a workbench, and it's me, and it's a camera. So you can look at me, or you can look at the word fucking bench, or not. You know, I used to do the videos where my head was in the corner yapping at you while you... Yeah, right. Okay. Let's get to the point. But hey, I'm in a great mood. Look at how nice that turned out. All that 40 years of turd all came off of there. We're going to remount the bridge. I saw it in one of the brief flashing moments of... There was someone that was overly concerned about the way I reinstalled the wood screws into the wood. Either they go in and they hold, or they go in and they don't. I don't over-tighten things. I don't crank things. It's just like, hey, then, you know, it's like tendonitis, carpal tunnel, all of the above. Sorry, guys. This is what it's going to be. And the thing is, it's got this nice ratchet on it. That's not the screw stripping. It's finished. It's not even going to tighten it very as much as you would by hand. That's it. I rest my case. I apologize to the world of wood screw engineers. And last I checked, after a screw's been cut through wood once and taken out and put back in, doesn't matter how careful you are, I don't think it's working as well as it was, but it's still going to work. Whoop-dee-doo.
Look at that.
I get it. This is good. This is one that I hate to say it, but the more I'm looking at it, and the more it's looking, once I put it back together, this might be something I want. It vanished. Someone broke in the house. A couple new pieces of sponge. But I forgot there was a little solder dilemma. You know. This is like the full service event here. Alright, we're not dog dicking around here. Make sure to always get a good half of them fumes. Just another tip from Dave. Wonderful. Wow, did I ever get a huff of that. It smells like burning underwear. And some of you may remember Dave installing the bridge without putting the ground wire back in. You see what happens? I could just be doing this all in my lonesome. There'd be nothing to criticize. No one would ever know. But just because I'm the fucking clown that I am, someone said, hey, you should make some YouTube videos. That's how it actually started. I used to just like, first I used to take a lot of pictures of the stuff that I did for people, just so I could show them, you know, this is what we did. And then I started making some videos. And then YouTube came along. Something like that. There. Let's try this again. What do you think? And, you know, of course, my entire numbnuts family, they're under the impression I'm down here talking to myself. Hats off to them, too. Once again, intricate final assembly. That's pretty good for a start. They'll adjust. Oh, and I didn't peek it with the camera, but the pots all date 1976 as well. Now, how on earth can my camera be running it's batteries. Okay. We're doing a live broadcast. Everybody needs to super chat me so I can super duper buy some batteries for my cameras. This is just retarded. It really is. I bought all new batteries and they're all garbage.
But this one can be the seasick cam. Oh, my stomach. I don't want to work on this guitar anymore.
Oh, it won't shut off either. Okay, so that brand new pick guard doesn't look so out of place now, does it? I just got to reinstall the nut, which is nothing more than two tiny little drops of... I use a little bit of model cement. The guys use a little bit of white glue. I don't like cyanoacrylate on a nut. I don't like using that. It's just a little too permanent and it can get away on you. You're really just holding the nut in place so it doesn't fall out or fall off when you have the strings off the guitar. It's the string tension is what really holds that down and where it should be. So let's find the strings. What else did I need to do? Nothing. Find the strings and set it up. And we're going to go from there. Geez, I hope I put enough foam under the pickups. Oh, hell yeah. Okay, let's get strings. I want to play this, dude. Someone keeps buying these strings. 100 to whatever the trick they are. Don't buy those.
105, 85, 70, 45. Maybe a 65 in there, or an 80. 45, 105, you can play around with the two in the middle, but 100.100 for the E string. Yeah, not me. Oh, that must have made a wonderful sound. Oh, are we going to do the bass string tutorial? Let's do it. Stringing your bass tutorial. Stand by. I'm going to start wearing these gloves all the time. Even to bed at night. What am I looking for? Oh, I'm looking for the snip snippers. Okay, here's our string. It's going in that hole. We go to that peg. We go to that peg. We go to that peg. One, two, three, past. Hair more. Maybe just a hair more. And if it's a little too much, no biggie, because we can take that away. But if it's a little too little, well, it's Goochville, isn't it? The Gooch. That's my guitar. Whoa, my old screwdriver. I gotta lube up these tuners. Because that ain't a machine. Let's just see. Maybe it is. I said my batteries are dying. Nah, these are pretty good and stiff. I got some stuff for that. And look at that. There we go. And right away, I can tell everything's all really out of whack because I took it all apart. But hey, give me a few minutes. We're going to get this going. And I'll take my gloves off. See, glad I checked before I went on. I have a frozen, it's frozen, adjustment screw. So, with that in mind, at least I didn't get all the strings on. Now I gotta take it right apart again. See what happens? It's always easy. Okay, here's where I'm at. I got this one to free up, but on very close inspection, I see that I'm not the first guy there, and one of the ears is busted off that, so I can't really grab it from that direction. And there's really not a lot sticking out on this side, so let me grab it with some vice grips and try and spin it out the other way. It's a gooch. Oh, it's a gooch for now. I'll be back in a minute. Yeah, so here I am, brokenhearted. I gotta try and get that out of there. And it's just so tiny to try and drill it for an easy out or anything. I gotta try and grab it from the back. Or just stop. Set this as the string height that it's gonna be. No, I can't do that. We can't. I've done so much work on the bass. Now I'm gonna leave it with this broken bit of shit. Okay, I gotta rethink this, and maybe I have a.
Well, sad. Like I said, we're brokenhearted at this point. I soaked 11, you know what, out of it. Cut a slot in the back, tried to grab it from the backside and spin it out, and it just all sheared off and fucked up and broke. So, if I had gotten it out, I could have put the guitar back together without that screw and found one in my junk or got one or whatever. But now that I can't get that out, I can't really put the guitar back together. So, on goes the bad stories. Dave gets on the phone, and we decide if we just look for another vintage style replacement bridge, which I think is the best solution anyway. And then when I get that, I will take one saddle off of it and put it on the original bridge. So all we've changed is the one saddle instead of the whole bridge. What a concept, huh? Okay. Until next time, that's going to be on hold because obviously we got to find a part now, you know, a part. It's going to take a week and $40 in shipping and fuck it. Okay, Cheers.